guys, Dev here, and today we'll finally be looking at the Frostval gift boxes that have finally opened. Now, everything has been released already except for the miscellaneous items, which has not been released yet. But before we go into that, I'll first like to show you guys the Frostval gift delivery, the final boss, which is Cabros and the cozy zombie dragon or something like that. Anyways, just to give you guys a short overview of this year's gifts, okay? I felt that they were pretty disappointing once again, and again we have another win set. I do not know what is up with the stuff this year. Oh my god. And I actually forgot my light armor. Okay, never mind, we'll just get enough SP then we'll just flee from this. I need to get my darkness armor because I got it set up for okay, so anyways, this will probably be a pretty long video. Hopefully it doesn't exceed 30 minutes. I'll try my best to keep it within the time limit so you guys don't get stuck watching a super long video. So yeah. Okay, so we're gonna need our light weapon as well, which we have, right, okay. Okay, wait, was that my darkness armor or was that my light armor? Okay, wait, we actually need the darkness armor. Okay, let's heal up first, and now we can get started. Okay, I won't be going through the Dev's Domain quest, okay? It's pretty much, the rewards are pretty much the same. You can get a permanent skull face, you can change your name and whatnot inside the domain, and I don't think they have any new rewards there, so unless I see something that's eye-catching in the forums, I probably won't be, you know, going through that. So anyways, the first one, we have the Cozy Zombie Rain Dragon. Right, this shouldn't be too difficult. Shields, we have our Eternal Twilight Regalia, and let us get started, right. Ooh, okay, I forgot to turn on the sound effects. Okay, let's see, today is Naga Day, that won't be really useful to us. We just want to kill him as quickly as possible. Alright, you can see this guy, nothing too special to him, immune to disease, immune to bleed, and -1000 initiative, and he also has this thing which can make you take darkness damage each round, but that's not too much of a big deal if you have strong darkness resist, and you can see he's starting to switch to ice damage, which he can do ice damage once in a while, but usually he'll do darkness, so that's not too worrying, so it's fine. Shall we heal up? Yeah, let's just finish him. One more hit ought to do it. Okay, and now we have Cabros, right? Cabros pretty standard, we fought him quite a long, fought him plenty of times before, so nothing too difficult. He's a bit tanky, I would say, 5536 HP, but still, nothing we really can't handle, so he's gonna do this very damaging darkness attack. Okay, and you can see here, I actually forgot to bring my healing spell. That's fine, we can just use a health pot. It's pretty much the same thing. I apologize for the lack of commentary, I really didn't know what else to say. So yeah, pretty easy fight. Well, I prefer a challenging fight though, it's been a little while, and you can see a Mercuria is gonna have her way with Cabros, if you know what I mean. And wow, okay. So anyways guys, the rewards weapons, you have a spoon in the form of a darkness magic weapon. Okay, I don't use magic weapon and the artwork is absolute bullshit, so I'm not gonna get that. But the armor, however, the sweater dragon mount, okay, this is basically the fire version of the earth dragon mount, or was it the griffin rider, can't really remember. Okay, so we have your titles here for the warmongers, and the only thing that's worth getting here is obviously the armor. So I will highly recommend you guys to get the sweater dragon mount armor, and it is really really very useful. But anyways, without further ado, let us start looking at the Frostval gifts and gift delivery rewards. Okay, so we'll start off with the cozy dragon rider mount. Okay, just hide the pet. Sweater dragon mount. Okay, we'll do without the shield. Pretty standard defenses, 48 melee magic. No, 48 for melee and range, and more defense for magic, 55. Okay. Now, one thing to note is that if you have actually done the Frostval quest beforehand, I'm not sure if I mentioned this in a previous video, but was it part 1 or part 2? You actually get the cozy Farzad Moglu shield. That is the best fire shield in the game, apart from Farzad Moglu, which went rare. So definitely get that shield as well if you guys haven't. Now, resist, okay, primary resist is fire with it doesn't really have a secondary resist. Okay, wind and ice at 51%, not fantastic, but yeah, you're pretty much standard armor. And oh, okay, so Guardian Dragon's gonna come out, and this is actually a fully offensive form when you're mounted. So let's see how much damage this can do without any boosting miss or whatever. 252, that's pretty weak. Wonder why. 224. Wow, this armor is really, really weak. Okay. You can dismount your dragon and it can shift your lean to a fully defensive form, and you can also gain a risk increase to your block rate. So let's see here. Haven't really seen any difference yet. Okay, I honestly I'm not sure if the armor is glitched or something, but why is it dealing so little damage? Did they nerf our damage or something? 100%, I shouldn't be dealing such low damage. Okay, mounting up your armor switches to fully offensive, and you also gain a boost to damage. Okay, that is slightly better. It's still pretty crappy though. Okay, so anyways, that is the armor. I believe it has a 3 hit as well. Let's see if we can get the 3 hit to activate. Nope. 3 hit, I believe the dragon breathes fire or something. So yeah. Okay, pretty rare, I suppose. It's not gonna happen anytime soon. So yeah, overall the artwork, honestly it doesn't look too bad. I mean, I would have preferred it without the, you know, sweater and stuff, but yeah, overall I think the artwork looks pretty good. And obviously it's just a reskin of a Zek token package item, which is very very generous of the staff. I really like that they kept the original ability. Okay, so you basically have it in the form of a fire armor instead, and finally we are able to fill the gap that is the fully defensive fire armor. So however, I was really hoping for an earth armor instead. We don't really have any mastercraft. Okay, so yeah, that's the breath attack. So it's 3 hits, it deals more damage. Okay, but anyways, enough of that. Now let us switch to the gift, the Frostval gifts. Okay, so the only thing we don't have yet is the miscellaneous item, so it doesn't matter. Okay, so this year's set is basically based off of Game of Thrones, if you guys actually watch it. Now, I did not know that initially because I don't watch Game of Thrones. I'm not a fan of it. I don't watch it at all. Okay, until I went to the forums and then I saw somebody talking about it. Initially, I thought it was just based off the game Murderer, in case you guys don't know. Okay, since it's Murderkillosity. Okay, murderer, some people call it werewolf. It's basically the same game. Okay, and it's actually a pretty popular game, at least in my country, for like, you know, school events, like they having orientation and whatnot. We always play that kind of game. So yeah. Anyways, on to the artwork, okay? The pet's artwork, it looks okay. It's not fantastic, but it's not horrible either. I really like the artwork of the armor. You can see here, it fits my helm perfectly well. It just looks epic, okay? I really like the nice black color and the armor and whatnot, okay? So this is a fully offensive wind armor, and you don't really see a lot of fully offensive wind armors, so I really like that. Shield artwork and weapon artwork fits pretty well with the armor, so very nice. However, apart from the artwork, the effects are pretty underwhelming in my opinion, right? So you can actually, okay, you can spend 100% Murderkillosity to reduce the damage you take by 3.6% for this battle by clicking on the belt of your armor. No. For your shield, I mean, okay, so the armor, what does the armor do? Oh, okay, so you can increase your weapon and spell damage or accuracy. Okay, clicking on the weapon, you can spend 100% of your Murderkillosity to gain 5% weapon damage for the current battle, and clicking on the pet, you can spend 40% Murderkillosity to have your pet deal extra 5% damage for the battle, and the spell, Dracarys, or I'm not sure how you pronounce it. Okay, armor is pretty nice. Okay, and you actually gain extra Murderkillosity 20% every time you use the spell. Damage wise, is decent damage. It's but basically you can have a maximum of 2000% Murderkillosity, and every time you defeat a foe, you gain a little bit of Murderkillosity. A bit similar to the Zombie X Master set we have a while back, whereby the more enemies you defeat, the more powerful it gets. Oh, and actually some monsters do not grant Murderkillosity, so I'm gonna go into a normal battle so you guys can see it better, okay? Samurai Warrior, okay, so it's 120% now. We don't have a light armor. Never mind, that's okay, we'll just use, okay, Winter Warrior, right, let's start. And honestly, okay, you actually have Infuse, oh, the skill is here. Infuse Might, you can consume 100% Murderkillosity to gain 5% weapon and spell damage. And you can also consume 100% Murderkillosity to gain plus 4.25 BTH to your weapon and spell. So, very nice, and honestly, the reason why I feel that it's underwhelming is because you have to fight through a few monsters to, you know, get the effects to activate. But that's not really the main point. I mean, you can basically have the effect active throughout the entire battle for like any of those strong boss battles, as long as you have enough Murderkillosity. However, I find that the reason why it's underwhelming is because of, okay, we just died, the percentages of that, and the death animation, okay, pretty normal, nothing too fanciful. Okay, it's because the percentages that you gain, the damage boost, the defense boost, whatever, that you gain is really too small. 5%, come on. Maybe they should up it to like 20%. Now keep in mind, the weapon does not have a special, so it actually deals extra 9% damage, at least that's what I think. Okay, info subs aren't fully out yet, so we don't really know, but I'm assuming that's the case, or either that or it has a very rare special which I have not seen yet throughout my whole testing. Okay, so fully offensive wind weapon, very nice artwork, very nice, but effect is underwhelming. What I'll recommend is they boost up the numbers. Okay, damage for weapon maybe 10%, shield maybe 10% as well. Okay, skills for the armor, basically just make everything 10%, and BTH maybe 5 or 10, you know, same thing for the pet. 10% will be better, 5% is just too small in my opinion, and I don't think you can click it more than once to have like stack up the damage and stuff like that, so it's not really that useful in my opinion. And once you get like a few 100% Murderkillosity, you can basically just activate the whole set throughout the whole battle and deal increased damage, increased BTH while taking decreased damage. So that's basically it, guys. Okay, overall, it's still kind of disappointing for the effect. However, I do really like the artwork of the set. If the staff can actually consider boosting up the effect, then I would say it's pretty good, even though a fully offensive wind armor isn't really what we're asking for. So anyways, guys, that's gonna wrap it up for this video. I hope you guys have enjoyed the video. If you have, be sure to give it a thumbs up. And do check out my other videos. For I post gaming videos every week, and of course do share the my videos with your friends and family and get them to subscribe to my channel. It'll really help me grow, and yeah, that's about it, guys. Thanks for watching.